especially in middle-aged women, if there is burning pain in the front foot under the metatarsal bones, numbness in the toes, and the feeling as if there is a pebble in the shoe while wearing shoes, it may be a Morton's neuroma. Although it gives the impression of a tumor when you hear its name, it's not. I guess you found this video while searching the internet as a patient diagnosed with Morton's neuroma. You will find the details in this video. Hi, I'm Dr. Gürkan. In this video, I will explain Morton's neuroma and the latest treatment methods from the point of view of an orthopedic surgeon. Neuroma refers to a benign tumor of the nerve. Morton's neuroma is not an actual tumor. As the American surgeon Thomas George Morton first described this condition in the medical literature in 1876, it is still called a tumor. It was perceived as a tumor due to the chronic trauma-induced fibrosis of the toe nerves, that is, connective tissue formation and thickening. We consider the great toe as the first toe and the pinky as the fifth toe. There are four interdigital spaces between these five toes. Morton's neuroma occurs between the second and third toes, most often in the third interval. That means it occurs between the third and fourth toes. A ligament connects the head part of the metatarsal bones. One nerve passes under each of these ligaments. This nerve divides into two to form one of the two nerves of each toe. Morton's neuroma is the thickening of the nerve under the ligament between the metatarsal bones in the part of this common toe nerve just before it splits into two. It is thought to be more common, especially in those who wear high heels. A kind of inflammation due to repetitive pressure and trauma in the region is caused by edema and thickening between nerve fibers. In other words, before the common toe nerve divides into the toes, it may be traumatized under the metatarsal bones or compressed under the thick ligament between them. According to another theory, it occurs after the nerve's blood supply is disrupted with this compression and is called ischemia. Most of the patients are women. Burning and numbness are felt in the affected toes. 17% of patients may describe a trauma at the beginning of the events. Half of the patients describe the feeling of having a pebble under the foot with the deterioration in sensation. The pain increases with walking, running, and tight shoes. In the beginning, removing the foot from the shoe and resting it may reduce the symptoms. However, 1/4 of the patients in the advanced stages of the disease state that they also have pain at rest. There is no visible swelling in these patients. The presence of pain is noticed when an experienced physician pinches the area with his fingers where Morton's neuroma expects to be. In the presence of 1 cm or larger neuroma, a popping sensation can be taken when it is moved between the fingers during the examination. Although an experienced radiologist can diagnose it with ultrasound, the most accurate diagnosis is made with MR imaging. Although neuroma can sometimes be seen on MRI of the foot taken for a different purpose, typical complaints may only be present in some patients. In my study, 1/3 of 57 patients had radiologically confirmed neuroma, but they had no complaints. In cases where the neuroma is larger than 5 mm, it may be more likely to cause complaints. As usual, treatment starts with the simplest and more harmless one. The first step is to inform the patient. This video I made serves this purpose. It will be easier for patients to protect themselves if they know the cause of the pain. On the other hand, patients need to be informed so they do not have to worry if it is a tumor. No need to fear its name, and it is not a must to be removed immediately. If this ailment is not treated, the patient will not have any other problems besides pain. Physicians' first recommendation must be wearing wide front and non-heeled shoes. For some patients, the complaints may decrease significantly even with this alone. In the second stage, steroid injection should be tried around the neuroma for patients who do not benefit from preventive methods. 2 or 3 injections can be made in 1 year. After 1 year, 1/3 of patients need surgery despite injections. Especially if the injection is made within the first year after the symptoms start, the patient will benefit more. In medical publications, it is seen that alcohol, capsaicin, and Botox injections can be applied around the neuroma apart from steroid injections. In addition, ESWT, also known as shockwave therapy, can be tried. Another treatment method is destroying the neuroma by creating regional heat with the help of a thick needle-like RF probe. RF is the initials of the radiofrequency method and can be seen in medical publications. I will comment on this in the next part of this video. Surgery can be done by incision on the backside of the foot or the sole. Making it from the backside of the foot is advantageous because the patient can bear the load earlier. It is seen that 85% of these patients are pain-free after 5 years or more. On the other hand, complaints continue at 15%. The reasons for this are: the diagnosis that caused pain was not made correctly. A significant portion of the patients had Morton's neuroma in the region between the adjacent toes, and the neuroma formed again after the surgery just behind the area that was removed. The adhesions caused the pressure on the rest of the nerve in the post-surgical area, and the nerve going to that area may have accessory branches. If complaints recur, a steroid injection is again the first choice of application. I'm performing this surgery, but I believe that personal experience is the weakest method of scientific evidence. So I will share with you the data contained in a review article published in 2017. As this article compares different treatment methods of 2025 patients, the result will be much more reliable in the context of various studies. With the choice of shoes and special insoles, 48 of the patients have improved more or less in 6 months. However, at the end of these 6 months, 81% success was achieved in the radiofrequency method, 71% in alcohol injection, and 51% in cortisone injection. When we look at these data, your comment may be that the radiofrequency method and alcohol injection is more effective. Another question we should ask here about the method's undesirable effects and the rate. Complications develop 5% in the radiofrequency process and 3% in alcohol injection. These are permanent pain, temporary nerve damage, infection, severe pain after the procedure, and wound problems on the skin. No complication of cortisone injection was reported. It achieved 88% success in the surgical remote group and 94% in the ligament release group. In ligament release, the ligament between the metatarsal bone compressing the nerve is released, but the nerve is preserved. There was no statistically significant difference between the patients who underwent surgery on the back of the foot and those who performed on the sole. It seems more advantageous to choose surgery from the back of the foot because it is more accessible and the patient's recovery will be shorter. Let me clarify a few questions you may ask. If this mass is removed, will there be numbness in the toes since we have removed the nerve? Since two nerves are going to each toe, the removal of one of them causes numbness, but this deficiency is mostly not noticed by the patient since the toes do not function like the fingers of the hand. What would you do if you had been diagnosed for the first time? Of course, it is most appropriate method to start with the most harmless shoe choices and then try injections or non-surgical procedures and go for a surgical removal if it does not heal. As a result, if the pain does not subside, the possibility of re-injection may come to fore. If radiofrequency is more successful than non-surgical methods, should I have it done? In addition to its success, if it fails, you should also consider the 5% complications that I mentioned earlier, namely pain or skin problems. Moreover, this radiofrequency device may not be accessible everywhere, as this video can be watched in different countries. In some countries, the cost of the probes to be used may exceed the surgery. In others, surgery is a costly treatment method. So, the price may be the factor in your choice. It is also helpful to ask whether your doctor is experienced in these methods. If the treating physician do not have experience in surgery or RF, you would not want him to make the first trial on you. If you have watched it so far, remember to press the like button to appreciate the effort and hit the subscribe button not to miss my videos with orthopedics, nutrition, and sports content. May you have active days where you always smile and do not experience health problems.